Hi, everyone.
Hello.
So it's been, almost 4 months?
Almost, yeah.
Almost 4 months since we made a video. It's been, a busy 4 months. I can't think of anything, though, that, really stands out for why we would have waited, 4 months.
I'm not really sure. So. We didn't have anything going on or anything.
No. I did find something downstairs, though.
It was just kind of hanging out. It's called a baby. And her name's Francesca. So yes, I use that term loosely.
I had a baby. Yes, I had the baby.
So this is baby Francesca, or as I call her, Taters.
No, he does not call her that. He does, but I don't like it. Francesca, yes.
I call her Frankie.
Yeah, I'll be honest. I can accept that, but I don't call her Frankie. I call her Francesca because that's her name.
So, baby Frankie's born.
Yep. She was 8 pounds, 5 ounces, and 21 inches long.
She's the runt of the family.
Yes, she was.
She's the smallest of all three.
Yeah, Isabel was 8'8". Demetrius was 9'2". He was jumbo. And then, and then Francesca was 8'5".
Yep. So, and she did good. She came out. She had a little bit less hair than what she's got here now.
Yeah, she doesn't have very much hair either.
No, but everything was good and healthy.
Mm-hmm.
So everything was good, and she's been really good.
She's a very good baby. She's like super baby. She doesn't cry hardly. She's really happy.
So let's back up. Let's talk about, because the last time we did a video, we were talking about how things were close, and we did some videos about how we didn't find out the gender ahead of time or anything like that. So first, I will admit, I was very, very nervous about having another girl. And obviously, since she's here, I'm a little better about it.
No, you're not. You're much better. And I knew because you were nervous, you were going to have a girl. So I knew that was going to happen.
Well, now that we have a teenage daughter.
She's really a teenager now.
Yeah, I am very nervous about having another girl. Considering what we're going through now.
Too late now.
No, but Frankie's good. And I'm very happy. We're both very happy.
She's a very good baby. Frankie. And the kids love her. And
everybody
come around.
We had some family come out to come stay with us.
Mm-hmm.
My sister. What happened was is that we had my sister, my mom, and your mom.
We're all lined up to come.
Yeah. So what we ended up doing was is we spaced everyone out. We told them, okay, you come this week, and then you come this week, and you come this week, just because we didn't know, obviously, when you were going to go into labor.
So
then we were always covered. There was always going to be an extra person here because, we have just one in the car, and I work, 45 minutes away. So if there was an emergency, there was someone here who could take Melissa to the hospital and then also be able to help out, if the kids needed to get picked up from school or something like that.
Yeah.
So... We had
Jenna come out first.
Yep.
And Jenna was great. She was able to take a really long time. She was here for basically 2 weeks. She was here for, and so she came out first, and she was here for 4 or 5 days? No.
Yeah, it was I think it was 4 days.
She came on a Wednesday, and then she was born on Sunday. Yeah. So.
And so Jenna came out, and we were, you had gone back to the doctor. And Frankie was Breach.
Yep.
A Frank Breach,
yeah. So, which means, basically means that you're...
Frank Breach.
Yeah.
Frank Breach.
Basically, Frank Breach means that the baby is Breach, which means, head up and not turned around they're supposed to be, but that their legs are basically in their face.
Yeah, so her legs were up this. She was facing out.
She was facing
out. So, facing the wrong direction.
Yeah, completely. Yeah.
And head up.
Head up. So, we had hoped that I had hoped, anyway, that she would switch, but... The doctors were not very optimistic that she would because they already knew she was a big baby.
And there were some things they said that they could try and do if they wanted to turn her.
It's called a conversion, and they physically take their hands and massage the baby through your stomach into the right position.
Mm-hmm.
But I was not willing to do that because I had heard a bunch of bad things about it. It's dangerous. You can go into labor. You can actually cause yourself to bleed, internal bleeding, and all this stuff. And I wasn't willing to do that. So they had said okay, so if the baby doesn't turn by this certain day, we're going to schedule a C-section. So we went ahead, and by 37 weeks, she hadn't turned.
Mm-hmm.
And so we scheduled the C-section.
And the C-section was scheduled for?
December 11th.
Okay. So we had totally written off that she was going to come naturally.
Yeah, because I figured I had no signs of labor or anything.
Mm-hmm. Like, no Braxton Hicks.
Nothing. Nothing. I went to the doctor. They checked me. They're like, nothing's going on. Here's the date. You know, come back on that date, and then we'll get you. You'll be in, you know, yep. ready. We'll give you the surgery.
We totally wrote it off. Like, there is no way she's coming early. December 11th was early anyway.
Yeah, that would have been early. Would have been 39 weeks exactly.
Yep. Yep. So. On December, on
December 5th.
Mm-hmm, December 5th, we had a night out, or a day out, basically. Like, we went to the mall, we went and walked around.
Yeah, we went everywhere.
We went and got Mexican food.
Spicy food.
Spicy Mexican food. So, basically, we did all the stuff that you're not supposed to do, or like, things you are supposed to do if you're trying to induce labor.
Yep.
And what happened?
At about 3 in the morning, it was like 2 in the morning, my water broke in bed. And I was like, oh, my water just broke. And I got up and I tried to wake him up and it didn't work.
So, story on that, because we had written it off so bad.
And because we had Jenna here with us. Jenna was already here.
It was a Saturday night. We normally watch a bad movie on Saturday night. Like, I was thinking, like, we're going to make it to December 11th. No problem. Like, we're going, no problem. We're going to make it there. So, I mean, I might have had like 6 or 7 beers or so.
More drinks than you probably should have had.
Definitely more than what I should have had.
Yeah.
And so then I went, I'll admit it, I was drunk.
and we went to bed. Late too, like at 12 maybe, midnight maybe?
Yeah, it was after midnight by the time we went to bed. And so then at 3 a.m., you wake up.
At 2, I wake up and the water broke and I'm like, okay, my water broke. And I tried to wake him up and he was like, nope, not going to wake him up. So then I went and called the hospital and said, like, listen, my water broke. And they're like, yep, come down right now. Don't wait, because once your water breaks, you only have, like, a certain amount of time before. Mm-hmm. And plus, that baby was breached, so they didn't want me to start to have labor. So then I finally woke him up and told him, like, it felt like something out of a movie. Like, my water just broke,
And then she asked, like, and are you okay to drive?
Yeah, can you drive? Do I need to drive? Because I wasn't in labor yet. So anyway, long story short, he woke up. We told Jenna we were going to go, and then we went to the hospital, which is only about 10 minutes away.
Yep. So we made it down there. Everything was fine.
Yep.
Went through the early part, like whatever that first stage is called. Went through that pretty quickly.
Yeah, like triage and all that.
Yeah, yeah. So they knew she was Frank, breech, and so they moved us along pretty quickly.
Because I was having, I was already having contractions.
Yeah.
They were like, oh, you're having contractions right now on the machine. They could see them. I'm like, oh, okay.
We have a story about the doctor. The doctor was hilarious.
But that's not a really appropriate conversation.
We will save that for our next video, where we'll dive, because this video is going to be a little long because we're catching it. Everyone up. So on our next video, we'll talk about the doctor and what he had to say.
I mean, he was a great doctor. I loved him.
He was good. In the delivery room, they moved really fast. They got her out real quick.
Yep.
And they were able to do some other stuff that needed to be done at the same time. So they were great. The hospital was great. What was the name of the hospital again?
It's Mercy. Gilbert Mercy.
Gilbert Mercy, yeah. Yes. So they were
hospital.
Great. Yeah. They took care of us really good. The nurses were good after the baby was born.
Yeah.
Everything was good. So, and she came home.
I came home
healthy.
2 days later and everything was fine. Yep.
And we got a lot more details with that kind of stuff to catch up on. Maybe I can get Melissa to start doing, her own videos to talk about some things, maybe describe some stuff about maybe breastfeeding and all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
So, but we want to introduce you to baby Frankie and talk about how she was born and she's here now. And we can't thank everyone enough for all the stuff that we got. We are totally prepared. In fact, we didn't have to buy diapers.
No, we didn't.
For like a month.
Actually, I just bought diapers for the first time like last week.
Yeah, really. So like 3 months.
Yeah.
We didn't have to buy diapers.
Yeah, she will be 4 months on the 6th, on April 6th. She'll be 4 months. And so we just barely bought diapers.
So, everything is good, and we're back. We're going to be back making videos now. The baby came. Our videos aren't going to be about,
pregnancy
and the gifts that we were getting and stuff like that. So we're going to turn this more into like vlog, into more like family vlogging.
Yep.
Yeah, family updates, so we can update everyone on what's going on with the family and some stuff that we have and things that we're doing and. The stuff about raising a teenager and a 10-year-old or a 9-year-old, but basically a 10-year-old and now a new, brand new baby. And so we're going to talk a lot about that stuff, just what's going on in our house and, turn it more into a regular family vlog.
Yep.
So look for that stuff once a week. Let us know if you think that's a good idea. You want to see some more stuff. If you want longer videos, mm-hmm. we're going to try and keep them to about 10 minutes long, you know, maybe shorter than that. But if you want to see longer, you want to see 20 or 30 minute videos, we could probably do that. If 10 minutes is too long, you want us to break them up into more videos, then we can do that. So just let us know what you think of the format that we're doing now and if you want to see any changes. And I think that's pretty much it. It catches everyone up to where we're at now. So look for a new video next week and a lot more videos to come soon. Say bye, Frankie.
Say bye, Francesca.
Bye. See you later.
Bye.